I swear, you guys, this milking station gets so dirty. Look at that mess. It's time to clean up. It up one time. Okay. Do you want me to show you how to do it?
Sure.
First, you put this thingy on the thingy, but the thing that I've done wrong in the past is I haven't pushed it through.
Can you sure you don't put anything else on the floor doing that?
Nope.
Are you sure? Wait, before you push it on.
Nope. So you do that and you seal it right there. See? Okay. Then you take, Okay. I have to go watch the video. There we go. Well, we got everything clean just in time for morning milking.
You filming me dropping hay?
Yes. You just dropped some right in my beautiful milking station. I told Kevin to build me an indoor milking station, but did he do it? No. Are you girls so excited to be in a nice, new, clean area? No, they just care about their grain. Luna's sniffing the grain over there. Let's give her a little handful. Hey, I'll give you a little bit, okay? There you go. Oh. Well, a lot of people have been asking about milking stars and if our does have earned them. They haven't yet. We are still working on it with the two first fresheners we have, Reba and here Prim. I don't know if Prim's gonna hit it. I think Reba will, though, her first year. So we're still working on them. They kitted late in the year, back in April. So we're still kind of mid to end of their milking season. So we're gonna push them through and see if they earn it. Okay, Prim, you're done. Let's make the switch. Come on. Come on. There you go. As much as I love that automatic milking machine, we still have to finish them out like this because if we use the machine to do the last bit, it can damage the teats. So, still gotta hand milk. Just the very last. Okay, come on. I thought you were done. Turn around. Come down this way. Bye. Make good choices today, okay? And finally, sweet little Reba. Gotta scoot your butt over. Come on. There you go. Reba is not a fan of being milked. She doesn't like the machine and she doesn't like being hand milked either, I think. She's so sweet otherwise, but goats are just different. They just have different personalities. That's a pretty good amount of milk for three little goats. I know planning healthy meals can feel overwhelming, not to mention it can be expensive to try to shop for all the healthy ingredients. Over the last 15 years, we've been trying to grow our own food on our little 1 acre in Arizona, but there's not always something to harvest. Our summers can be really brutal, and so there are times of the year that I have to stock up on healthy food. This is my secret on how I do it. It's called Thrive Market, and they guarantee to have the cheapest prices on healthy food. Not only are they sponsoring today's video, I've worked with them to give you guys a great deal, so be sure to check out the link in the description below. Thrive Market is an online marketplace. It's where everybody goes online to buy healthier options. You can search for foods based on your diet preferences, whether you're trying to just eat healthier and cleaner, or whether you're trying to do keto or vegetarian or any of those other things. But you can also search by sales, which is my favorite way to do it. Now, if you get the annual membership instead of the monthly membership, it is way cheaper, only $5 a month. And if you don't like it within the first 30 days, they'll refund it, no questions asked. So it's totally a risk-free trial. And even better, for every membership, they give a free membership to somebody in need. A teacher, a first responder, a veteran. My orders have always gotten me big savings. Just look at what I got in today's order. After this really hot summer, we don't have very much growing in the garden, so I stocked up on a bunch of veggies and fruits. We've got stir fry blends, broccoli, strawberries, cherries, sweet potatoes, spinach, and I even tried out these cool zucchini hash browns that I really wanna try. They guarantee to have the cheapest prices, and they stand by this. So if you find a cheaper price somewhere else, they will match it. Orders over $49 ship free, and frozen foods over $120 ship free. So when you go the frozen route, just be sure to stock up. And the best part is you can do all of that grocery shopping in minutes at home. So if you want to get that deal, it's thrivemarket.com/wheatemandreap. They're going to give you 30% off your first order and a free gift worth $60. It's the first link in the description if you want to check that out. Remember, it's 30% off, a free gift to stock up your pantry and freezer full of healthy foods. So kind of a fun thing happened today. I got my first order of cajeta. I've been making this for a while. It's a really great way to use up any excess milk, and it's a really simple recipe. It just takes a lot of stirring. I've tried to figure out ways to sell this, and I can't really figure out a way to get past all the different laws or make it legal, because there's no real rule when I am actually sourcing the milk from my backyard. But my sister-in-law and her coworkers asked for a few jars, and so I'm gonna make some for them today. I'm also gonna make some for Lydia, because she's missing this fall treat and she wants to share it with her roommates. Cajeta is different than caramel, because caramel is made with cream and butter and corn syrup, whereas cajeta is just a caramel sauce. It's never gonna really thicken to the point where it's a caramel chew. It's just gonna stay in the sauce form. The only downside is it takes a long time to stir, so Kevin is actually gonna help me out. He said, "I'll sit in a chair and I'll stir it for you," and that's what he did, and here we are 2 hours later. Yes, it takes 2 full hours. I was thinking it'd be cool to have one of those pot stirrers that you can get that automatically stirs it, or they make industrial sized pots that can stir. After it's done, I'll just strain it to get any little bits out and then pour it into our jars. Once it cools, it's the perfect dip for pretzels or apples. It's like a caramel sauce, but it has that cinnamon flavor in it, and it has the nice rich goat's milk flavor, which our goat's milk just tastes like regular cow's milk, so there's not like a pungent or strong taste to it. It's just very creamy, since our goats have the highest butter fat of any breed. Gotta put my little cute labels on there with baby Tatum on the front. Doesn't that look cute? And now we just deliver to our customers. So I had to make a decision today to sell one of our goats. And that's because the truth is I really haven't been feeling that well ever since I got COVID. I've had really bad heart palpitations, and I haven't been able to sleep because they've kept me up all night. And so I've just been trying to work with a cardiologist and figure out what it is. It's not electrolytes. It's not any of the things you would think it is. So anyways, I've decided that I really need to be mindful of this next year's kidding season in case I'm not feeling as good. And so I've decided to part with Prim. And the reason why is because, so I've had my share of chronic health issues over the years, and I thought I had a pretty good handle on it, but I still deal with my back pain from my scoliosis. I still deal with other stuff. But if you've ever had a chronic illness, something that's lasted a really long time, you know how important it is to have distractions or have hobbies or have something else to look forward to. And so the farm has been great from that. It's kept me really active and it's kept me focusing on something other than myself. It's gotten me outside and it's really contributed a lot to my mental health to just really feel like that I am able to do things and that I am that I am able to accomplish things and have dreams and goals like other people. But at the same time, sometimes I have to really watch myself and make sure I don't go too overboard. So as I look at, wow, my eyes are really puffy right now. So as I look at the next year and that I still want to continue with my goals, but that I want to make it more manageable, I know I'm going to have to, you know, make cuts in the spring. And I know for sure, as I look at all of my goats, I know for sure that the one that I would most likely cut would be Prim. And that's just because she just doesn't have quite the body type I'm looking for. I bought Prim from Johnson Family Farmstead in Oregon, who are great. And we both had hoped, we were kind of taking a chance, we both hoped that Prim would have her dam's udder because her dam's udder is really well known in the goat world and it's really desirable. So I took a chance, we brought Prim here and raised her up for a year, bred her, and then it was like the day it arrived, we get to see the udder. And it was all right. It didn't really seem like she had her dam's udder. So I decided to just milk her throughout the year and look at it, see it develop and see if there were any changes that were gonna happen. And we didn't really see that. So unfortunately, this happens a lot. Genetics are just, sometimes it feels just like such a gamble. And you hope that you get the thing that you want as you work towards your goal in your herd, but you don't always get it. One of the reasons why having a high attached udder is such an important thing in the goat world is it means that that goat is gonna have more longevity. So an udder that's already hanging down as a one-year-old means it's gonna hang a lot further down as they get older. And so that's something that as goat owners we're always really, really wanting to get. We want this really nice, well-attached mammary system. So I made the decision along with Jennifer from Johnson Family Farmstead that we think Prim's gonna be better as a backyard milker. She's a really great milker. She has a nice soft udder texture and she could be worked with. You know, she could be improved upon. So since Prim is already bred, which is great, she's bred to Lancelot, we're gonna sell her to this sweet little family in California. They're gonna take her, she's gonna kid on their farm, we can see the kids and we can keep in touch. But I know that I'm not gonna want to keep the kids because I have so many other Lancelot babies that are gonna be born out of does that I know are gonna have a little bit better structure and udder. It's just one of those decisions we have to make a lot along the way, and in the spring we're gonna have to make more. So I decided, because I'm still recovering, not feeling too hot right now, but I still wanna work towards my goals and I still wanna do things, I just thought it'd be a good idea to sell Prim now, get her settled in her home where she can kid in January, and then I can just focus on the 6 does left and I can just put my effort into that. So I know Prim is probably a favorite for a lot of you, and she is really sweet, but I think this is the best option. The goats that are left that will kid this year are going to be Honey, who was bred to Lancelot, Reba, who was bred to both Finnick and Lancelot, Winona was bred to Lancelot, Daphne, who was bred to Lancelot, Shania, who was bred to Lancelot, and then River, that was bred to Lancelot. So we've only got a possible one Finnick baby, but we've got a lot of Lancelot kids to choose from that I'm hoping will improve all the things that I'm hoping for, and I'm excited to continue to do the things that I love to do despite how I feel. There you go. There's a last little treat. Even though you probably don't need it. Look, she's perfect.
No problem, we can. Oh,
no. You'll be good. Then you won't have all the wind on you.
Oh.
All right, guys, this is Prim's new family. And they live in California, and they have an Instagram account, so you guys can follow along. And this is Christina and Brian and Blake, and they're excited because they have experience with goats, so they actually have a doe that's like due any minute, so they gotta rush home, because like, it's always one that takes forever, and you're waiting and waiting and waiting. Yeah. So they're gonna take Prim, and then they're gonna let us know and give us updates on the kids.
Yes. We will.
So we wanna know what the kids look like, and if we have doelings.
Because
that's, yeah, because we tried that with Prim. Prim's back there all nice and cozy. She's good, she's good. And yeah. So, thanks for taking her. It'll be fun.
Thank you.
We're so excited for Prim.
Well, thanks for joining us in today's video. It's kind of sad. I always get real sad when I have to let goats go. Whether it's the babies or the adults, I feel like it's equal sadness. But I'm happy with her new family. I think that she's gonna do great, and I'm really excited to see the kids. So it'll be nice to have a little bit easier kidding season in the spring. I don't know if it's just this year, like having the kids leave, that was a stress. Getting sick right before they left was sort of stressful. It was pretty stressful. So I think this will make for a little bit easier kidding season. We still will have 6 does due, so it'll be a bit crazy, but it'll be manageable.